Tyson felt the need for a little attention, so she went running to Nancy Carr, who thought that the story was so touching, the whole world should know about your affair.
Yeah, but where did this photograph come from? That's what I want to know.
Well, I think your little friend studied under the paparazzi school of photojournalism.
Well, it's just a photograph of a man in bandages. It doesn't identify him in any way. It could be anybody.
Well, read it, darling, and have your hanky ready for the tears, because it is so romantic.
Oh, come on, baby.
Romeo and Juliet would seem like casual acquaintances next to you.
Well, you know what this is. It's just newspaper hype. They use it to sell newspapers. It doesn't mean a thing.
Oh, please, read it. See how cultured you are.
Hmm. Shakespeare, Keats, Shelley. Well, it is true. I read quite a bit to pass the time when I was there.
Is that how you put the make on Valerie Bryson?
Raven, come on. I was stuck in a hospital for 2 months. Valerie Bryson was a diversion for me, nothing more.
Well, I'm not worried.
Well, you've got no reason to.
But I am worried about our secret. Listen to this. Valerie Bryson last saw her faceless lieutenant some 3 years ago. 2 weeks after they said goodbye, the bandages that prevented her from seeing his face were removed. But to this day, she has no idea what face appeared. But now, there is a glimmer of hope that she will see Jim Diedrichsen again face to face, if the speculation proves true that the ex-soldier is residing somewhere in the vicinity of Monticello. Now, why would they think that?
I don't know.
I think they want to find Jim Diedrichsen. And if they want to find him, they just might find Jefferson Brown. Article starts off some sort of massive manhunt.
Don't worry about it, Angel.
How can you be so calm? Everything could be ruined.
Use your common sense. No one knows what Jim Diedrichsen looks like. And you can believe me, he's not about to come forward and announce his presence.
I just hope you covered your tracks.
Jim Diedrichsen is someone who is not going to be found. You look at the newspaper tomorrow and it'll be full of other human interest stories. Jim Diedrichsen will be old news.
I just hope you're right.
Story.
Yeah, it turned out pretty well.
Do you really think you'll see your faceless lieutenant again?
Oh, I don't know. I guess we'll just have to wait and see.
You know, this might be good for business. People may come to the Crown Studios just to see the famous Valerie Bryson.
I didn't mean to become a household word. Oh, Carla, do you think it was a mistake? My letting him publish the story?
Well, you had a reason, didn't you? You wanted to see your friend again, I'm sure.
Yeah, if only out of curiosity.
Nothing more than that?
No. I got over my feelings for Jim a long time ago.
Out of sight, out of mind. Works that way sometimes. But it's surprising how feelings can come rushing back when you see someone again. Someone you really cared for. Valerie, have you heard about our cover for Bizarre?
Oh, yes, Carl, that's fabulous.
Yeah. Only one element missing now. Martine hasn't agreed to do it.
Oh, you're kidding. She doesn't want to be a cover girl?
She thinks it's too much exposure as a model. She still thinks of herself as a dancer, you know. She was exquisite as a dancer. Fluid, graceful, but with something else, just a certain tension that just kept you right on the edge of your chair. When I saw her in Paris, she was just not to be believed.
Carla, do you mean that? You saw Martine dance in Paris?
Yes, I did. I saw Martine dance in Paris, but I didn't actually meet her until she posed by the punch bowl at the Whitney House. Oh. Ah, big favor.
something.
You didn't check this product?
No, I wish I could stay, but I promised Miles and Nicole I'd babysit for Adam so they could go out to dinner.
Please say hello for me.
I will. You know, I wish I had invited you when I wasn't so pressed for time. It's just that I had to talk to you.
I'm glad you did. It's been too long, Jody.
Yes, it has. It's been very hectic for me the past few months. I don't think I've had 10 minutes to myself.
I blame myself for the time that's gone between us. I'm very sorry.
Why?
I couldn't stand to see you while you were under the influence of Skyler Whitney. Do you understand?
Yes, I do. I know you didn't like my working for Sky.
You oughtn't understand, Jody. I was never angry or resentful. I was just very worried about you.
Well, you don't have to worry now.
So it's definite. Have you told Skyler Whitney that you were going to leave the company?
Yes, I did.
And? You accepted it?
Well, he wasn't exactly very gracious about it, but what choice did he have?
Jody, I admire you for having the courage to break with Skyler Whitney. I'm very proud of you. And if he does try to get you to change your mind, be strong.
I will. Especially since I have Gavin on my side.
Of course you have Gavin. And his support is not unprofessional.
No. No, we've become very close. The truth is, I'm in love with him, Martine.
I know.
You do?
I've known that for some time.
I really don't know how it happened. I mean, maybe it was because we were spending so much time together and shared similar interests. So I was just going along, minding my own business, and one day it was just there, and there was no denying it.
You can't deny love, Judy.
Martine, I can't help but feel that somewhere along the line I've hurt you.
You did not steal my lover, if that's what you think. You merely fell in love with someone that I once cared for very much, that's all.
Is it really over between you and Gavin?
What existed between Gavin and I was just a dream.
Martine, what I have with Gavin, I don't want it to be a dream. I want it to be real.
I hope it is real, Judy. Your happiness means a lot to me.
And I want it to be forever. Or is that asking for too much?
Forever is a very long time, Judy.
Do you think I'm being naive?
I hope your relationship is going to be forever, if that's what you want. But if it's not, you should be happy with what you get now. Live for the moment. Get everything you can out of the time you have to spend together. This way, even if it does end, you can look back with no regrets.
Sounds like very good advice.
There is something to be taken from every relationship.
Is that how you feel?
You know, Gavin helped me to grow as a person. And in a funny way, I don't regret the time I spent with Keller Whitney.
What about Collier Wells? Do you regret him?
Collier Wells was a boy, disguised as a man. A little more maturity on his part, on mine as well, I suppose. And we might have been able to make it work.
I'm sorry it turned out the way it did.
Can I tell you something?
Of course you can.
I think of Collier every day. He's with me all the time.
So you do have regrets?
There are exceptions for every rule, especially those I make up.
You still love him, don't you?
Maybe I could. If I ever found him again.
You have been at me all night about that gun. Are you going to let me at least drink my beer and be?
No. Now that you've stuffed yourself sufficiently, there's only one thing to do. That's go back to the studio, get that silly pea shoot of yours, and walk off this meal and throw it in the river.
Oh, no, I'm not going to take a moonlit walk with you down by the river. Uh-uh, you're not my type.
That is not funny, Gavin. Look, you have got to get rid of this pistol, and the sooner the better.
Look, buddy, I appreciate your concern. I don't like having the gun around any more than you.
Then why don't you get rid of it?
I can't.
Why not? I need it. Oh, Gavin Wiley, mild-mannered dance instructor, suddenly needs to carry firearms?
That's right. I needed to protect myself.
That's what guys like me are for, remember?
Look, maybe if you'd been through what I've been through, you'd understand. I still wake up nights in a cold sweat thinking about what Gunther did to me in that alley. He's not going to do it again.
Oh, so now you think if you had a weapon with you, it wouldn't have been any different?
I don't know. I would have put up a good fight, I can tell you that.
Gavin, it probably would have turned out a whole lot worse.
Who knows? Who knows? It's ancient history, Calvin. But I do feel better having a gun in the studio after Gunther's threat.
Okay. Hey, hey. Okay, have it your way. Just don't say you haven't been warned. Okay, so no walk by the river. So what are you going to do tonight?
I don't know. I thought I'd give Jody a call later, see if I can help her babysit.
Babysit, huh? I remember I used to call it that.
What are you going to do?
Oh, no, there isn't anybody in town for me to call. Or, just maybe there is.
I've already been through today's mail, Marcus, so why don't you just put that thing down?
Any checks in that mail, lady?
You'll only make it worse for yourself.
My problem's gonna be over just as soon as you give me some money so I can blow this town.
You know, you've got one hell of a nerve. You already set me with a $10,000 bail bond.
So what's a few more bucks between friends? Walk over some more cash, put on my tab.
Marcus, you've got to give yourself up.
Thanks for the suggestion.
They'll catch you, you know that.
I got friends who'll take care of me. All I got to do is get to them.
If you run away now, you'll be running for the rest of your life.
If I don't run away, I'm good for a nice long stretch. The rent is right, but everything about the deal stinks, so no thank you, lady.
You know, I might be able to work something out with the DA. He's a friend of mine. It might not be so bad for you.
If you don't give me some money right now, you ain't gonna have to worry about paying back no $10,000 or anything else, because you're gonna be one dead lawyer.
This plan of yours isn't going to work. Face it and give yourself up.
I'm not going back to jail. No way. Come on, you're supposed to be one of those smart college ladies. Figured out how to get your hands on that 10 grand. Might have enough brains in that pretty head to figure out how to get some more.
Don't you know anything about the bail bond system? That was not my $10,000.
Whose was it then? The Tooth Fairy?
I went to a bail bondsman. All I had to do was to put up 10% of that money, and I had to borrow that from a friend. But if you skip town, I'll have to pay back the entire amount, and believe me, I'll be paying it back for years.
Yeah, not as many years as they'll put me away for if I don't run away.
You don't know that.
Look, I did mug that lady. That's good for 5 years stretching a joint for sure. Now, don't answer it.
I've got to.
No, you don't.
Now, look, Marcus, I had a date tonight, and my boyfriend is a cop. Now, I was supposed to meet him downstairs right about now. If I don't answer that phone, he's going to worry about me, and he might come up here. Now, you don't want that kind of trouble now, do you?
All right, answer. Tell him you got to work late.
Scott and Nelson, attorneys at law, Didi Bannister speaking.
My. Don't you sound official this evening?
Hello, Calvin.
Hi.
I called your apartment, but I didn't get any answers, so I figured a legal crusader like yourself is probably burning the midnight oil.
Yes, I am pretty busy right now.
Yeah, well, you know what
they say about all work and no play. Listen, why don't you let me drag you away from those briefs and subpoenas and stuff?
I don't think I can make it tonight, Calvin.
Come on, you can even take the picture. You have to buy the popcorn, but what could be fairer?
I'm very selective when it comes to movies.
Yeah, so?
The only movie I would even consider seeing tonight is The Beatles' Second Picture.
The what?
You know, The Beatles' Second Picture. It's that or nothing, Calvin. Goodbye. There, I think that got rid of him. Hi, Ben. What's it?
Sid, you like The Beatles?
Yeah. Crazy about what?
I was just trying to figure out the title of one of their movies.
Hard Day's Night? That's the first one.
Yeah, no, it's the second. What's the title of the second one?
The second one. Help, I need somebody. Help.
Thank you.
I've done right today.
Oh, you have a rough day?
I just haven't been able to focus my attention on anything I've been doing. My mind's been wandering a lot.
Well, what's the matter?
It was more difficult than I thought reading this story about you and Jim.
You're just being silly. My relationship with Jim ended 3 years ago.
I hate to say this, but I hope this article doesn't produce the results that it's supposed to. I hate to see the former faceless wonder show up without those wrappings.
Well, you're really uptight about this, aren't you?
A reunion between you and the lieutenant might produce a tremendous follow-up article for Nancy, but I'd hate to see it happen.
Well, I'm flattered to hear that. But I'll tell you something, Mr. McGrath. You have no competition, okay? Let's drop the whole subject and just go out and have a good time tonight.
You got yourself a good one.
I gotta lock up. Let me get my keys.
Okay. No matter what you say, you must still be curious a little.
About what?
About what Jim Dietrichson would look like in this picture without those bandages on.
I thought we weren't going to talk about that anymore. But you're right, I would.
Well, who knows? You might find out.
You want to do something funny, Kelly?
Sure, I could use a good laugh right now.
It's occurred to me that I've heard Jim's voice somewhere lately. I just wish I could remember where it was.
Well, he has been on your mind a lot lately. You know, the power of suggestion can do strange things.
But I'm not imagining, Kelly. I know I've heard it somewhere.
So, Valerie, you're trying to find Jim Dietrichson, huh? Well, we're gonna...
How you doing, boss?
Where the hell have you been, Gunther?
Out, out, out.
What kind of an answer is that?
Well, now, don't get your feathers all ruffled. I have been taking care of business.
Really, huh?
Well, I'm all set, boss. I mean, I have my affairs in order, and I am all set to be killed. I dropped by the Wiley dance studio this evening. Twinkle Toes was out, so I let myself in, if you know what I mean. I mean, that lock was just like butter. And I found his little pop gun, and I took these out. Voila.
Gunther, for God's sake, don't be a fool.
Huh? What's your problem?
Mrs. Whitney is in the house. How would you like for her to see these, Gunther? For God's sakes, try to be a little bit careful, will you?
Well, I was careful. I was careful enough to make sure there's nothing but blanks in Wiley's gun. I mean, when he shoots me, he ain't gonna hit a thing.
Good work, huh?
Yeah. And when he pulls that trigger, something very interesting is gonna happen. Would you like to see?
See what?
Shoot me.
What?
Right now. Now, come on, come on, come
on. I'm in no mood for games.
Now, put your little finger out like a six shooter right there and plop me full of lead. Come on. Come on, just do it. Shoot me. Come on. Just one little bitty shot. Shoot me.
Bang.
Ah. You got me.
How did you do that?
It's just like in Hollywood, Mr. Whitney. See that? You put a little bag under your shirt with some red ink in it. You squeeze it. Instant blood. I guess I better get myself cleaned up.
Huh?